Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Problem Solving Strategy 6, Make a Chart or Table. Some math problems are easier to solve if the information is organized in a chart or a table. Are you ready to learn more? Before watching this video, it will be helpful if you watch the video called Problem Solving Strategy 4, Find the Pattern. Because within a chart or a table, you will often find a pattern. Making a chart or table helps you to organize information in a word problem. It also helps you see patterns within the problem. Let's look at an example to understand what I mean. Stella ran a lemonade stand for 5 days. On the first day, she made $1. Every day after that, she made $2 more than the previous day. How much money did Stella make in all after 5 days? We know that we have to add to solve this problem because it says in all. But there is also a pattern to find. How do we know? Stella does not make the same amount of money each day. Each day she made $2 more than the day before. Go Stella! So we know the pattern will be increasing in number. A really neat way to solve this problem is to organize the information in a chart or a table. We need to track the number of days that Stella ran her lemonade stand. We also need to keep track of the amount of money that Stella made each and every day. We can organize this information in a chart just like this one. Now, let's fill in this chart. We know that Stella ran a lemonade stand for 5 days. Let's list the number of days in the chart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We know that on the first day, Stella made $1. Let's write that next to day one. Now we need to figure out the rest of the pattern to complete the chart and to get our answer. So every day after the first day, Stella made $2 more than the previous day, which means $2 more than the day before. Okay. That means on day two, Stella made $3. $1 from the previous day plus $2 more equals $3. We continue to fill in the rest of the chart in the same way. On day three, Stella made $2 more than $3. So $3 plus $2 equals $5 on day three. Are you beginning to see the pattern? The chart makes it easy to see, doesn't it? On day four, Stella made $2 more than $5. So $5 plus $2 equals $7 on just day four. And on day five, Stella made $2 more than $7. $7 plus $2 equals $9. Great! Let's see what our final answer is. It's always wise to go back to the original problem. The question asks, how much money did Stella make in all after 5 days? At first, you might look at the chart and say that on the fifth day, Stella made $9. So our answer is none. But that is incorrect. If we look at the question again, in all means all the days together, not just on day five. So we have one more step to solve this problem. We need to add all of the money that Stella made because she did make money each day, not just on the fifth. Luckily, the chart makes it easy for us to add since it's all neatly organized. $1 plus $3, plus $5, plus $7, plus $9. Stella made $25. Wow, Stella made some great money with her lemonade stand. And there you have it. Organizing information in a chart is another strategy for solving word problems that can add to your treasury of math skills. Practice this strategy in our fun games and quizzes. And remember to always be clever.